Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Civilization 6. We are in episode 20. And last week, we built our new city down here. We have another settler working their way over here. Going to build here. And Montezuma of the Aztecs over here has been sending apostles against me and trying to convert my cities. He successfully converted Ottawa, which is something we're going to have to fix. But, he might have just promoted himself to next on the list. Interesting how he does not regard me as unfriendly. But yeah, the next apostle we can build is going to come over here and fix Ottawa. And I'm endeavoring to get this city here big as quickly as possible. There's one thing right there. We have 11 trade routes we can build. But I don't really want to build any, so. Build your workshop. Alright, settler has arrived over here. I don't think this is a very good spot, but you are also going to buy a builder. And a granary. Also, I guess I need to look into building some archaeologists, just because it's something I'm apparently going to need to do at some point. All right. This is legit Alexandria.
Then you drive out where the storm clouds swallow, and the sound of your oar blades falling hollow, as all we have left through the months to follow.
Yay. Alright, Madrid. You have work to do. Alright, is an archaeologist something that you can build? It is not. Although you might have to have a particular kind of district to do it too, so. Let's see if I tried to build it here in Pala. Yes, it can build an archaeologist, okay. Alright, going to need to do a little work here in this city. Because it needs lots of stuff. Another Aztec apostle has appeared from nowhere. That annoys me more than a little bit. All right. It is done. Montezuma has declared himself next on the list. One's his capital. There. Tenochtitlan. Do you actually need food? Yes, you do. Alright. Can't afford to buy you a builder, but, yeah, I'll get you a builder over there as soon as I can. Alright, Madrid has finally finished building whatever it was trying to build. Kind of needed that on at the same time, but. Alright, where's the Grove? Is that the Grove? Nope, that's a mine. It's an entertainment district, that's a lumber mill. There's the Grove, or the Preserve, sorry. Breathtaking. Breathtaking. It's got a lot of unimproved breathtaking tiles around it. So we're gonna build that. Oh, yeah, I'm going to go ahead and denounce him. Yeah, I fear you, Montezuma. That is exactly what I did, what I'm doing. You have poked the bear. It's time to, accept that that was a poor decision on your part. A Golden Age War. I might do that. Okay. I like it how I had one unit in this city and one unit in this city, and they have opted to go opposite directions around the world to get two tiles that are next to each other. Well, that's less than ideal. That's very bad, actually. Wasn't expecting an armada of barbarian relics here. If I lose my most powerful army to 3,000-year-old barbarian units that have just been floating here for centuries, That's going to be great shame, but also at the same time, very stupid. Since, I mean, they don't even need heavy weapons. Just take out your machine guns, shoot at these boats, you'll blow them to pieces. Yes, I know machine guns are not that powerful, but you could very easily kill the crew. Repair the outer defenses. And nope, there's going to keep coming. They're using arrows. Okay, that guy at least has cannons. That's something at least. I really can't believe that just happened. Build a mechanized army. And you come over here and kill all those pirates. And it is more than a little frustrating that we've sent half of our army over there to start this war, and the other half of our army got killed by a unit they could have blinked at and killed on the land.
A favorable eye upon thy creature, who implores thy goodness and compassion. One day there will be no borders, no boundaries, no flags, and no countries, and the only passports will be the heart.
All right. I don't really have any units, so we don't have to worry about that one. That. Ooh. All right. I'm tempted to tell Melbourne to start building the giant death robot. But no, you have other things to do. Like build a workshop so you can build the giant death robot faster. Yeah, build the Colossus. Okay. We're going to appoint him in Madrid. Now this is what happens. This is your punishment. What, did he build a city? Oh, he built another city here, I guess, that got close enough to my territory. I think. Admiral is such a stupid unit. Haha! You have decided to avenge your brethren? That's unwise of you. Whoa. He actually converted Madrid? How? I mean, I could make another apostle somewhere else and bring it over here and fix this, but I mean, that would have taken me like 12 apostles to pull that off. Well, Montezuma has definitely earned my ire. And he's gonna get it. I mean, seeing as how he is the lowest tech person on the entire game, when the artillery arrives, we'll probably just pick the fight with the artillery and just bombard him into submission. There they are, in fact. I mean, he won't be able to field anything that can stop them. Oh, I already have an apostle. Yeah, you get over here and you fix this. I can't actually do any of these. Would you stop asking me to do them? No, this is... Half the usual. Yeah. You should not have poked the bear. I actually don't know if this thing can even move in to take a city. It looks like no, it can't. All right, religion. Converts in 166 turns. That's quite a while. You. Can't quite afford an apostle yet. That's fine. All right, can you buy a military unit of some distinction? No, because everything is ungodly expensive. We have a machine gun corps. Maybe they can do it. Crossbowman.
Complete becomes complete. The crooked becomes straight. The empty becomes full.
Oh, you're over here. All right, you get to Madrid and get the holy city back under our control. You build a trader. It's another ranged unit. I don't know if it can take a city or not. You got plenty. Build armor. Well, that's not good.
Distracted from distraction by distraction.
Why didn't you attack him? You can only attack cities. Okay. Okay. Well, no. Still not right. There we go. Neither of these units can actually do anything. Alright, Venice. You have pike and shot. What is pike and shot? Cardiff doesn't seem to have a military. I have 4,000 monies. I cannot afford any units.
It ascends from the earth to the heaven, and it again descends to the earth and receives the...
Barbarians have an ironclad. That's nice. All right, the apostle did his good work. Got the holy city of Hellenism back into the control of Hellenism. The rocket guy up here, that way I can hit multiple cities at once. You can just stay here and keep shooting this place. That works. And you're gonna move over here. And yeah, you don't have line of sight with anything. War isn't going very well because we don't have any units that can capture cities. I mean, honestly, at the moment, I would try to get suzerain with these guys just so that I could commandeer their warriors. Attack range is 4, which means from here, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, Tenosha's line is in range. We just need some, just need our rocket guy to get around here where he can actually see the city, and then this guy can blast it. How many turns until we have an army? 27.
At Rhodes was set up a colossus of 70 cubits high, representing the sun. The artist expended as much bronze in it as seemed likely to create a dearth in the mines.
Oh, you can reach Alexandria. That's good. Because my goal is to try to build this up as big as possible, but I am wondering where the food is coming from. Alright, it's generating 5. It might require the trade route to actually be established for it to work. I don't know. Oh, well, that's unacceptable. Get over there and convert that. That's part of the problem. Alright, we can make another apostle. Which we're going to make at Madrid, now that Madrid has its, as the cardinal. All right, guys. I believe this is where we will be calling this episode. And this has been a week of disasters, I guess would be a good way to describe it. But in 25 turns, we will have our mechanized infantry army constructed. And then the war with the Aztecs will be over. And basically the war with everybody will be over because nobody will be able to fight against that. And over here in Amphipolis, we're 16 turns away from building the launcher satellite, which will let us see the world map. I don't know if that just reveals unexplored territory or if that gets rid of fog of war. I would like for it to get rid of fog of war, but I doubt it does. But then after that, it will begin construction of the giant death robot. And I hope that Harald is ready for it, because by the time that gets built, we'll probably be working on him. Or maybe Basil. We shall see. But I believe we will call it here. Until next week, guys, I want to thank y'all for joining me. I hope y'all enjoyed it. I'll see y'all next time. And have a good day.